what happens when I'm looking for this? I don't have to look anywhere, because if I look for somewhere, but I have been told that human life must attain to bliss, because that is our nature. I've been told that Sachidanand somehow is what I am, so I must attain to bliss.
No, I have to discover.
I have to discover it.
Whatever. I'm already there.
Whatever. But you know, I'm not experiencing it, so. So what happens when I'm looking for bliss?
Agitations will happen.
This looking for bliss itself is an
unbliss. If that is the word, I don't know whether dictionary that word is there or not. I don't know.
So looking for bliss itself is a detractment from.
I have to establish.
Maybe I already am. But
I am already.
Because, but I don't know whether I am.
I have to uncover it.
I don't know whether I am bliss. But what I know for sure is. If I'm searching for bliss, that search cannot be blissful. Because search means I'm not yet there.
I've lost it. That's why I'm searching.
So maybe this concept that Sachidananda is my swabhav, this concept itself is interfering with my swabhav. You know, swabhav means that which is there even without tutoring. Even before somebody told me that I am Sachidanand, if I am actually Sachidanand, then I would be Sachidanand even without knowing the word Sachidanand. But the day somebody comes to me and tutors me that my swabhav is Sachidanand, now what do I start doing?
I start searching for
Sachidanand. Now what am I searching for? I'm searching for a word.
Satchit, I've already searched and found.
Yes, yes.
Now Ananda is left.
Something is left. I'm searching for something, right? Which is a word and image. So from a state where I was that, now I have been pushed into a state where I'm searching for that.
One thing to be clarified, that bliss, definition of bliss, what we are looking as a bliss, is a worldly object, will never come in. I mean, you explained a very great eye-opening example with this existence. Existence itself is a bliss. We are not satisfied with that. We want non-agitation to be part of it. Or agitation which is conducive to our plans. So that is one thing. So, coming back to the core, I mean the question. How
suppose I don't know. Suppose I'm the first man. I'm the first man on this earth. I don't know the opinions. But I am the first man. First man as existence would produce. First complete healthy man. Won't I have Sachidanand Swabhav?
You ought to.
But there are no Upanishads to tell me that.
Of course.
Now, am I lacking anything in life?
No.
The day the instruction comes.
Okay.
The day this knowledge comes that attaining to bliss is a worthy goal of life, my life becomes disturbed.
Basically, in layman's language or in a lighter side of it, like I'm not having a Aadhaar card. So I've been told that you don't have, doesn't mean I'm Aadhaarless.
Yes, yes, yes.
So I have to be told that I have to get Aadhaar, then only I will get my LPG cylinder.
Yes.
That doesn't mean I will become Indian citizen only if I have Aadhaar.
Yes. But you know what happens? You start feeling, really it happens. You start feeling a little bit less of a citizen if you don't have an Aadhaar card or a passport or a PAN card or a passport.
Blah, blah, blah.
Now, this is so strange. As if your very citizenship has been diminished.
Rather, prelude or has come from your this talk, that if I am told that I have to attain Sachidanand, then I feel incompleteness, though I might be
already
in a meditative position. But then I search, okay, was this correct or something else is Sachidanand?
You know, think of someone who is sitting here nicely.
Mm-hmm.
Huh? Nicely.
Mm-hmm.
Just sitting. And then I go up to him and say, meditate. And here are the list of methods. You could use either of them. Pick up something that suits your personality, meditate. Now what have I done to him?
You have given him...
I have shaken him out of his meditativeness. And what have I given him? Ostensibly, I am a well-wisher who has given him a list of methods of meditation. But I am saying now...
You might have transcended them already.
We all are already...
But this debate will lead us to that. We should not read Upanishads.
But that's what the Upanishads are saying. Forget us.
Sir, in my view, this spiritualism is very easy. But...
When you say
it does not come by any reading or any, but some grace is necessary.
Maybe that grace is there, but in asking for it, you keep it away.
It comes. Grace is necessary.
It does not come, because to come it should have been absent at some point.
Yes.
Maybe it is there, but our beliefs, we have an image of grace. What is grace? We confuse grace with luck. If something nice happens to me, if randomness favors me, then I say this is grace. For us, grace and luck are one and the same things. They are not.
Yeah.
And if you are unlucky, let's say you get run over by a truck, would you say that grace is still shining on you?
This is just an happening. Maybe anything.
And people do get run over, don't they? And it's highly unlucky thing to happen. And then when it happens, and in that moment, there will be hardly anybody who will still be full of gratitude. Now grace is gone. But grace is still there. Grace is still there. You are unlucky, but grace is there.
Every time, it is there.
So it doesn't come.
It is every time, yeah.